guys, so in this video I'm going to take you through a flow to really help you find your breath. So every movement that we make is going to be matched with a breath. And we try and make the movement last the whole of the breath. So from the beginning to the end of the inhale, the movement rolls into the beginning and the end of the exhale. And it becomes this cycle of movement and breath as we flow together today. So let's start by coming to a child's pose. So coming down onto the mat, pointing your toes back, sending your hips to your heels, and extending the hands down against the earth.
Place the forehead to the ground and take a deep breath in through the nose and a big sigh to let it go. Inhale. And exhale. With your next inhale, start to peel the hips away from the heels, the shoulders come over the wrists. And as you exhale, push back hips to your heels.
Now make it a little bit more active. So tuck the toes, come to the fingertips, inhale forwards. And exhale, pushing back. Inhale, come forwards. This time place the whole of the palms to the earth. And you're going to start to make kind of circles with the hips. So using the whole of the breath, starting to find a little bit of engagement through the core. And then three breaths back the other way. Use your inhale to come back to a tabletop. So root down through the hands. So the hands are about shoulder width apart, the hips in the same width as the knees, so the knees stack underneath the hips. Then the tops of the feet to the ground. Lengthen the forehead away from the sit bones. Take an inhale breath. Exhale, tuck the toes and lift the hips, downward facing dog. And just arriving in your downward facing dog, maybe bending one knee then the other. And then straightening both legs, but allow the knees to be soft if that keeps the spine long. Take an inhale, ripple all the way forward, shoulders over the wrists, and without a pause, you start to bend the knees and lift your seat, making a wave like water with the body. Inhale. And exhale. One more time, inhale. And exhale. Take an inhale breath. And exhale, big sigh. Float the right leg high with your next breath. Exhale, slowly step the foot between the palms. Rise up with a high lunge on your inhale. And exhale, let's take a twist. Good, inhale, come back to center, all the way to the tip of the breath. And exhale, twist to the other side, find your inner thighs. Inhale, come back to center. And exhale, place the hands either side of the foot. Take an inhale, look forward. And exhale, slide the right leg up and back behind you. Exhale, place the foot to the earth. Inhale, ripple all the way forward. Use the whole of your breath. And exhale, take it all the way back. Left side. Inhale, raise the leg high. Exhale, slowly step the foot between the palms. Inhale, root through the whole of the feet as you rise up high lunge. And exhale, take a twist to your left. Engage the inner thighs. Keep the core switched on. Inhale, use your breath to come back to center. And exhale, twist open to the right. Inhale, back to center. And exhale, hands to the earth. Look forwards and exhale, take the left leg high. Place the foot to the ground, inhale to the top. And this time, exhale, place your knees to the earth. Sit back onto the heels. and keep the toes tucked. So one of the places that I find it most challenging to stay with an authentic breath is in a challenging pose like toe stretch, where it can get really uncomfortable. So just allow the breath to roll between the inhalation and the exhalation. If it's too much to be here, you can place blocks underneath the hands. And breathing. Continuous flow of breath. And without a pause between the inhalation and exhalation. Place the hands in front of the knees. Tap the tops of the feet to the ground for a moment. And then tuck the toes again. Push through the hands and come into a forward fold at the back of the mat. Take a deep breath. Feel the back of the ribcage expand. And an exhale to soften down. And again, inhale. And then begin to pat the hands all the way to the front. Take the shoulders over the wrists on an inhale. And exhale, lower the hips down, draw the shoulders down the back of the body. Untuck the toes so the tops of the feet come to the ground. So if this is too much on the lower back, you can come down and be in a cobra pose instead. But otherwise, we're lifting like an upward facing dog, turning the inner arms in towards each other. Take a breath in and exhale, lower the chest back down to the earth. Tuck your toes, inhale, push to the hands, and exhale, find your downward facing dog. Let's take those ripples with the spine, inhale, come all the way forward. The birds are so noisy out here, it's beautiful, exhale. Pushing it back. Inhale to ripple forwards. And exhale all the way back. Very slowly use the breath to walk the feet all the way to the top of the mat. Scoop the core and bring your feet to touch. Then bend your knees, chair pose. Inhale, lengthen the navel. And exhale, take a twist to the right side. And inhale, come back to center. And exhale, take a twist to the left. Inhale, come back to center. And exhale, push through the feet, bring the hands to the heart. And just close the eyes, take a moment to be here, connecting to your breath. Let your awareness travel down through the soles of your feet. So as you root down through the feet, spread the toes. Feel the inside and outside edges of the feet connect with the earth. And then try to pull up through the thighs a little bit more. So you start to feel Mula Bandha, if you haven't already, this engagement of the root lock lifting, like the pelvic floor engages. Keep the left leg rooting down. Take a breath in and a sigh to release. And shift the weight to the left foot. Keep your left hip drawing in and bring your right knee to your chest. Take a breath, lengthen your spine. And exhale, take your right knee to the right side. As you inhale, let the hand travel down to the ankle. And exhale, place the sole of the foot on the inside of the thigh. Now use the inner thigh muscle. Engage the front and back of the leg. Bring the hands to the heart. And maybe this is where you stay. Or perhaps you take the arms over your head with an inhalation. Root down through the foot. Keep lifting through Mula Bandha, drawing the lower navel in. Good. Take an inhale. Bring the hands back down. Exhale here. Inhale. Bring your foot back to center. Bring your knee back to center. And exhale, release it to the earth. Shake out the hands, shake out the feet. And then let's swap to the other side. So spread the right toes, keep the inner thigh engaged so we're not popping out the hips, so draw it in and take an inhale to bring your knee into your chest. Exhale here, drop the hip, drop the shoulders. Inhale, open up the leg to the side. Good, and exhale, let the hands start to travel down. Inhale, bending the sole of the foot to the inner thigh. And exhale to arrive here. Squeeze your glute, inner thigh switches on. Inhale, hands to the heart. Let the breath soften the shoulders. And perhaps from here you take an inhale and raise your arms over your head. Good, exhale, draw your navel in. Inhale, bring the hands to the heart. And exhale, hold it here. Inhale, bring the knee into center. And exhale, place the foot to the ground. Have a good shake of the hands and the feet. And come to stand again at the top of the mat if you moved away. Take an inhale, reach the arms over your head. And exhale, fold forwards, palms to the earth. Look up halfway on an inhale. Exhale, step back to a downward facing dog. Take a breath as you inhale, ripple all the way forwards. And exhale, bend your knees, float your hips high. Inhale all the way forwards. And exhale to take it back. Last time, inhale, come all the way forwards. This time, lower your knees to the floor. Send your hips to your heels. And then take 5 breaths in your child's pose. The hands can be extended or they can be back by your feet. I'm gonna come up to sit so that you can hear me a little bit better because it's windy out here, but stay as you are in your child's pose. Feel this sense of expansion as the breath moves in and out of the body. Notice the lengthening and the space that you're creating through this meditation on your breath. This continuous flow, this continuous life moving in and out of your body. And we're going to close the rest of the practice with a meditation on the breath. You can stay here in child's pose. You can bring yourself to a seated meditation pose. Or you can allow the body to come to the earth for a shavasana. So settling into whichever of those options serve you best. The eyes are closed. And the anchor of our awareness is the breath. All the noise in the background here, or the distractions wherever you are. Try to allow as much of your awareness to ride on the movement of the breath in and out of your body. Still in the breath, if there's any holding or tension, any pauses between the inhalation and the exhalation. And see if you can come to this smooth, continuous breath, drawing in and out. Your practice. by making an offering. Let the work that we do here on the mat serve something much, much greater than ourselves. Allow it to be shared with somebody that you love, and offer it up. Offer up your energy, your commitment, your practice. Send your breath, your awareness, your intention their way, and let this beautiful work ripple out to touch others beyond ourselves.